Shalom Aleichem. Peace be to you, dear friends. I am your brother Mario Joseph. Welcome to another episode of Philokalia Ministry. In this video, I am going to tell you the difference between meditation and prayer. Many times when you hear the voice meditation, when you hear the word meditation, immediately you think about prayer. Immediately we say meditation and prayer. Is it the same or is there any difference? It's very difficult to explain, but for this video and for your understanding, let me explain in a simple way. Meditation is the time when you listen to the voice of God. And how do you listen to the voice of God? Initial stage, you can hear God only through the written word. So there is a Bible in your hand. So when you read the word of God, you meditate on that word, you think about that word, and that is called the meditation. And simple thinking is not enough. If you go deeply into meditation, there will not be nothing except you and the voice of God. You know, it seems that if you are meditating on the word of God very deeply, suppose if the snake comes on your body, if it jumps on your body, it will not bite. Why? Because snakes bites only when the snake is afraid of you. When you are deeply meditating on the word of God, you don't have any other emotion. The snake are not afraid and they won't bite you. So my brothers and sisters, that much deeply you must meditate after reading Bible. When you are meditating, definitely God will speak to you. That will be a silent voice in you, a joyful voice in you, an inspiration in you. And once if you get that beauty and the taste of that word of God, automatically you will have a thirst to speak to God in return. Because now God is speaking to you and you are overflowed with joy, automatically you will have the tendency to speak to Him. So once if you begin to speak to Him, that is called prayer. So prayer is the consequences of meditation. So meditation is the beginning of every spiritual activities. So my brothers and sisters, whenever you get a time, and if in that case I will say every day morning, at least 10 to 15 minutes you must meditate. So morning you read a portion from Bible and deeply meditate on it, definitely God will speak to you and you will be inspired to speak to Him, and that is called prayer. Now in this video I am going to teach you 6 ways how you can meditate every day morning. The first way we read in Psalms 119 verses 15, I will meditate on thy precepts and fix my eye on thy way. So the first meditation is always about the law of God, the statutes of God. You know, when I say meditate on law of God, people think about to meditate about 10 commandments. Of course, that is, but that is not the command according to New Testament. The fulfillment of those commands completed in the New Testament is the love of God. Love your God with all your heart and love your neighbor. Love the entire nature. So it is the law of love. So every day morning, you must meditate about your life thinking, did I do anything wrong against the love of God? What I mean, did I think anything evil today? Did I say anything evil today? Did I hurt anyone today? Did I hurt the nature today? Did I hurt any animal today? Did I do anything wrong to anything or anyone? And if you keep meditating every day morning about this, you know, automatically you will grow into holiness, because you will realize that, oh, I did that mistake. I said that way. I hurt so and so by bad comment and by bad voice and by bad look. And, you know, you automatically will understand you will never do any hurt. Even you will not put any waste on the road because you know that it is hurting the nature. So this is how you and I can be holy, by meditating about His love. I mean, His law. The second thing what we have to meditate, we read from Psalms 119 verses 15 to 27. But let me read only verses 15. I will meditate on thy precepts and fix my eye on thy way. Make me understand the way of precepts, and I will meditate on thy wondrous works. I will meditate on thy wondrous work. So the second meditation is the meditation about the wondrous work of God. I mean the miracle work of God. Very often we must think how great our God by seeing His powerful, marvelous works. Look at the nature and thank Him. Look at the sky, look at the sea, look at the road, look at the vehicle, look at the human being, look at the animal, and you have many things to thank Him. If nothing, people think that miracle is only which is beyond the natural things. For example, when a blind man gets healing, you say, God did a miracle. But I think, why there should be a blind man? My both eyes are functioning very well without any sickness or ailments. That itself is a miracle for me. You mean that someone should break my eye, then God must repair it, that is miracle? No, nobody broke my eye yet. That is miracle for me. No infection, no viruses, nothing affected my eye. That is miracle for me. See, when I am talking to you, I am making some noise and you are understanding many things, correct? Isn't it? I'm making some noise, but you are understanding many things. That language itself is a miracle. When you are listening to me, your cholesterol and sugar and pressure is monetized by someone. You are not aware that someone is God. And if you look at the nature, so-called nature is marvelous and wonderful, and you have to thank God all the time. Here in Kerala, one lady, while she was saying rosary, there began a fragrance in the rosary, and it became a big miracle for everyone, and people went there. I could not go because lack of money. There was no money for me to travel there. But somebody mocked at me saying that you are not believing in miracle. I said, you're wrong. I plucked a flower and gave to him and I said, in this flower there is 14 feathers and each feather is a different color and different smell. Smell and see. See, if my God can give a different smell in one flower, you know, by giving different fragrance in each leaves, I think that God is powerful and he can give smell for anything. He can give aroma or fragrance for anything. So for me, no need to praise God by seeing that rosary or betting the fragrance of the rosary. So-called the nature is marvelous and wonderful, and I thank God. My brothers and sisters, if you look at the nature, the entire nature will teach you how wonderful our Almighty God is. Number three, what we have to meditate is Psalms 143 verses 5. I remember the days of old. I meditate on all that thou hast done. You must meditate about your olden days, what God have done yesterday, day before yesterday. You know, when you are sitting early morning to meditate, think about your past life. Past life means, you know, 5 years before, where were you, and 10 years before, 20 years before, 15 years before. You just meditate how God guided you each moment of your life. I always say thank you, Lord, in a different way. You know why? At the age of 20, my emotion and my ideas and my dream was very small dream for my life. And I prayed for it and God did not give me that. That's why I murmur and backbited and I said, God is not listening to my prayer. But thank God, God did not give me that dream because that was smaller than where I am today. If I would have attained that dream today, I would have not been here as Mario Joseph in front of you with Philokalia. So my brothers and sisters, you also meditate about your yesterdays. When you think, you will know that many things you dreamed in your childhood, you didn't get it, but you are in a much higher position today. And many things you are praying today for tomorrow, but that may be a small thing in the eyes of God, and God wants to lead you in a good place. So meditate about how God guided you last days and thank him for everything. And if you really meditate on yesterdays, you will know how God saved you from an accident, from a disease, from a natural calamity, from a divorce, or from a fighting, or from a cheating. From many places, he saved us. Think about that and praise him every day. Number four, what we have to meditate is Psalms chapter 1 verses 2. Psalms chapter 1 verses 2. But his delight in the law of the Lord. So delight in the law of God. So God is asking you to delight, to be joyful, to be happy all the time. You must think about your happiness. Many times people think that enjoyment is a happiness. I think enjoyment is different and happiness is different. Many times people think that pleasure is a peace. Pleasure is different and peace is different. We must think about the peace. You see, once if you realize that Almighty God is your Father and he's holding a hand and walking in front of you, guiding you every day, every steps, then you will be at ease. You will understand that nothing to worry, because what all things I have is given by the Lord, and anytime he can take it. Even my life belongs to him. So I belongs to him. So I don't have anything to gain. I don't have anything to lose. So you will never be worried on earth. I think the moment when you don't worry about life, you will enjoy peace. That is why Jesus said, I give you my peace. The world cannot give you, and the world cannot understand, and the world cannot take it out. I think that peace is something very important. You see, most of the time we Christians, you know what happened to us? We think about our tomorrow. Tomorrow, how to do, how to go, how to, you know, when you are thinking about tomorrow, you're forgetting to live now. And many Christians, you know what they think? They think about yesterday, all the mistakes, what they did, and they are living on the past. So some people are living on the past and some people living on the future, but nobody is living on present. But the Saint Paul, through the Saint Paul, God Almighty says, say, again I rejoice. Rejoice always in the Lord. So Christians are the people, they should rejoice every moment. That's why we must meditate about joy. So when you meditate, you know, you will be at present. What the Bible wants to say, live at present. At present, be at ease mentally. Number five, what we have to meditate, we read in the book of Joshua chapter 1 verses 8. Joshua chapter 1 verses 8. This is very important, my brothers and sisters. Please listen carefully. This book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth, but you shall meditate on it day and night, that you may be careful to do according to all that is written in it. For then you shall make your way prosperous, and then you shall have good success. So Bible says if you meditate on the word of God and if you obey the word of God, then you will have prosperity and you will receive success. So my brothers and sisters, the fifth meditation, what you have to do, you have to meditate about your prosperity and about your success, future success. So early morning, after reading few minute Bible, you just close your eye and meditate about your dream, what you want to attain in this life tomorrow. That may be you want to buy a car, or you want to buy an apartment, or you want to go to a particular country to settle down, or you want to write an exam, or you want to go for an interview, you want to get a job, or you want to get a life partner, or you want to get a son or daughter, whatever it may be. You have lot of dreams to attain in this life. So now, early morning, after reading Bible for a few minutes, just close your eyes and meditate on the word of God. And if you say, I am ready to obey your word, you see, meditate on the word of God and be ready to obey it and do obedience to the word of God. Then the third, you meditate on this, what you need. Definitely that you will get. I didn't say, the Joshua 1:8 says, I want you to memorize that word, because definitely all those who memorize this word and recite this word and act on this word, if you live on this word, definitely your success is in your hand and you will enjoy it. Number six, what we have to meditate early morning, that is Colossians chapter 3 verses 1. Colossians chapter 3 verses 1. The new life in Christ, if then you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Wow. The new life in Christ. If then you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of the Father. The sixth meditation should be life after death. You see, many times people think that this life is only for this earth. I don't believe that. You see, I'm sitting in a room and recording this video. There is a wall. Behind this wall, there are many things which I haven't seen. I didn't see. But I cannot say there is nothing. There are many things. The same way after death, I didn't see anything, but I cannot say that there is nothing. When I am sitting at my terrace evening, I can see a lot of stars on the sky. One day I saw a small star, it is tiny. But my baby, while she was talking to me, she said, that may be bigger than earth, who knows, daddy. That is what the sign says. There are big, big stars which is much, much bigger than the earth. And how can I say that there is no another world? Maybe there are many people on the other galaxies looking at the earth and say there is no people, who knows. We cannot say that there is nothing. There is something after death. Here in Kerala, there is a camera which is used 120 years before to record some movie, and still that camera is functioning, it seems. It is functioning, it seems. Man-made camera lens remains for 100 years or more than 100. And do you think that God made my lens, my eyes only for 50 years or 70 years? No. This physical eye, you may visibly see and say it is for 80 years or 100 years. But the inner eye is for eternity. God created me for eternity. That's why Jesus died and rose, and he's still alive. And the same thing is for me and for you. Where he went, he will come and take us. So we have an eternal life. Think about eternal life very often. Many times we Christians go to church and pray only for this monetary benefit. Today I need some food. Today I need a house. Today I need a car. And today I need a wife. Today I need children. Everything for monetary. But God calls you to attain his eternal life. And Jesus came only for that. So my brothers and sisters, even when you are enjoying this earthly life, remember about your life after death and secure your eternity and continue your spiritual life. So in this video, I have taught you six ways to meditate. And if you can practice this every day morning, definitely the success and prosperity is yours, my brothers and sisters. And hereafter, I am going to bring out new video every day for you, you know, for us to learn how to meditate the word of God and grow in the word of God. For that, you have to do one thing, my brothers and sisters. Please subscribe my YouTube channel, Philokalia Official in English. And please ask your friends also to subscribe to this channel, Philokalia Official in English. May Almighty God bless you, and peace be with you.